Hey everyone, a very good morning to all of you. Myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs. So let's begin today's current affairs video, which can be useful for you if you are an aspirant of RBI SEBI NABARD. Now guys, before moving ahead, the students who are watching me for the first time, the information for you all is that you can download this video from the Telegram channel of ours. The link is in description below. Also guys, many students ask me in the comments only that how can you guys download the Spotlight magazine. So for that also, the link is provided in the description. You just have to click on that link and follow the process in order to download the Spotlight. No charge is there for Spotlight magazine. It's just that you have to sign up on our website in order to download the monthly magazine, follow the current affairs of the daily, follow the daily PDFs as well as attempt the daily quizzes. So here we have the first question. What is the national average score in the state of foundational literacy and numeracy in India report? So first of all, this report is very important, is a very important report. It has been released by the Economic Advisory Council to the Prime Minister's office. So we all know that this EAC to PM, the Economic Advisory Council to PM, is one office which does not release its reports very frequently. Okay, there are just one or two reports that are released by this office. This fact only makes the report all the more important. So now let's have a look at the answer of this question. That is the national average score in the state of foundational literacy and numeracy in India. So guys, here the right answer is option E, 48.38. First of all, I have already told you that this council has released the report, but who chairs this council? So it is Vivek Deberoy. He chairs this council. This report has been prepared by this Institute for Competitiveness. The report is released by this office, but the actual work on the report has been done by this institute. Do remember the name of the institution that has prepared this report, okay? Because this can also become a tricky question for you. Now, this report assesses foundational learning and numeracy skills among the students of states, of different states and union territories of India. So it includes five domains are there, and in those pillars there are 41 indicators. I'm not saying 41 each, cumulatively 41 indicators are there that are divided into five pillars. So what are those five pillars? Educational infrastructure, what kind of infrastructure is there in the schools, and remember we are talking about the foundational literacy, foundational learning, therefore the focus is on schools only, okay? So educational infrastructure, access to education, basic health, learning outcomes, and governance. So this is basically a holistic report that is not only looking at the learning outcomes of the students, but also looking at the dimensions that affect a child's life, a child's learning outcome, okay? Be it the technology deprivation. So we can see that in rural areas, in tier 3, 4, 5, 6 cities, there are many households where the children do not have the access to the mobile phone, okay? So that is also counted in this report. That's just one example that I have given you of technological deprivation. There can be other forms of deprivation that a child might suffer. And all those deprivations, all those factors affect the learning outcome of the child. And this is counted in this report. So it is basically a holistic report. So India is committed to achieve the SDGs by 2030, and therefore in line with India's commitment, this index has also included the zero hunger goal. Basically, how are the states performing in terms of zero hunger, particularly among the children, because this report is focused on the foundational learning and numeracy skills of the children below the years 10 years of age, okay? So that's the area where they are focusing on right now, even if we are talking about the zero hunger goal. Good health and well-being, access to education, okay? So guys, here is the table of the results. So this report has divided the states into four categories: large state, small, northeast, and union territories. In the large states, we have West Bengal, then Tamil Nadu, Maharashtra. In small states, Kerala, Himachal Pradesh, Punjab. नॉर्थ ईस्ट में मिजोरम, सिक्किम, मणिपुर, यूटीज में लक्षद्वीप, दिल्ली, पुडुचेरी. ओके, सो दीज आर दी टॉप स्टेट्स दैट हैव परफॉर्म्ड रियली गुड इन द रैंकिंग्स. ओवरऑल इफ वी टॉक अबाउट द ओवरऑल परफॉर्मेंस, देन केरला इज द बेस्ट, बिहार इज द वर्स्ट. ओके, सो दैट्स द सिनेरियो. नाउ इफ यू लुक एट द बॉटम स्कोरर्स, देन यू नीड टू पे अटेंशन टू टू थिंग्स. फर्स्ट थिंग इज दैट द रैंकिंग्स दैट आई हैव गिवन, दे आर इन द डिसेंडिंग ऑर्डर. बेसिकली द नॉटेंडिंग ऑर्डर, द वर्स्ट स्कोर इज देयर, द लोएस्ट स्कोर इज एट द टॉप. बेसिकली बिहार हैज द 9th रैंक इन दिस लिस्ट, विच हैज टोटल 9 स्टेट्स. देन उत्तर प्रदेश at 8th, then Madhya Pradesh. I hope now you can easily understand the way I have mentioned the states in this table. Okay, so in small states category, Jharkhand, Odisha and Telangana. Now the second point that I was highlighting is that in the bottom line, you can just memorize the state that is the worst performing in each category. Okay, Jharkhand, then we have Arunachal Pradesh, then we have Ladakh. If you are preparing for RBI SEBI NABARD, if you are targeting some state level PCS examinations, then you need to take care of the state to which you belong. Okay, so suppose if you belong to Meghalaya, then you need to know about Meghalaya also. What ranking does it stand in this report? This is also your responsibility to know. But if you are appearing for the national level exams like the RBI SEBI NABARD, then remembering the very worst state would do for you. Okay, moving ahead, what are the highlights of this report? So according to this report, states have performed particularly worst in the governance pillar, because half of the states have a score that is below the national average. National average he is 28.05, so this is very low. So पहले तो नेशनल एवरेज ही कम है, एंड अबव दैट मोर देन हाफ ऑफ द स्टेट्स आर नॉट इवन मैचिंग द नेशनल लेवल ऑल्सो, नेशनल एवरेज ऑल्सो. इन एक्सेस टू एजुकेशन पिलर वी हैव लार्ज स्टेट्स विच हैव अ वेरी ह्यूज पॉपुलेशन लाइक राजस्थान, गुजरात एंड बिहार. सो दीज स्टेट्स डू नॉट हैव any significant access to education. Children are not able to access the education. So because of these states, the national average is also low, but particularly the averages of these states are low, therefore they are highlighted, and the governments of these states need to work towards improving the access to education. Northeastern states are relatively performing well. In the education pillar, Andhra Pradesh, basically access to education pillar, Andhra Pradesh has outperformed Kerala. So this is another important point, because Andhra Pradesh, Kerala is one state that performs really good in all the socio-economic parameters or indices that we have, particularly the indices that are released by the government organizations like Niti Aayog, etc. So Kerala is the state that is being outperformed by Andhra Pradesh, that too in terms of access to education. So this makes it all the more significant. So do pay attention that Andhra Pradesh is the state that has outperformed Kerala in the access to education pillar. Next is, there is a huge gap between the scores of Kerala, which is 67.95, and the rest of the states of India. Now guys, I could provide you with all these scores of all these states, but I did not provide you with the scores deliberately, because if I had provided you, first of all, it would become very hectic for you to memorize the scores of each and every state, and that too of so many states. We have four categories in which we have toppers and the worst performers. So it will hamper your preparation. Secondly, the examiner does not go into this much of depth that they would ask you the scores of a particular state if we are talking about this national level report. So only the important averages, only the important percentages or scores are highlighted and mentioned here. Okay, so I would advise you to not go into the details of the scores of each and every state from the report. But if you want that, then you can do so. As I told you that if you are preparing for any state PCS, then it is your responsibility to know the performance of that state in a particular index or report. Moving back, so Kerala's score is 67.95, which is way ahead from many of the other states. This vast variation is observed in learning outcomes and educational infrastructure. Okay, so if we talk about the pillar of learning outcome and the education infrastructure, so in dono pillars mein Kerala has performed really well, and the score of Kerala is way higher, way above than the scores of other states. Only 17 states and 4 union territories have scored above the national average of the index of foundational literacy and numeracy. So national average is of most importance. Next question is, how many problem areas are addressed in the Sprint 04 Market Tech Hackathon? So guys, here the right answer is 5. Now this hackathon was organized during the Infinity Forum, which I have taught you some days back in one of my daily current affairs videos only. Therefore, I'm going to ask you the theme of this forum. Okay, do mention it in the comment section below. So as far as this hackathon is concerned, you need to know that every hackathon is organized by the organizations in order to have innovative solutions. So this is also following the footsteps. Now this is one of its kind hackathon that is being organized by a regulator. IFSCA is a regulator, International Financial Services Centers Authority. It is the regulator of IFSC, which is located in Gift City, Gandhinagar. Okay, next point here is that IFSCA and GIFT City are organizing it with NSE, National Stock Exchange. These are the partner organizations, and I don't think that you need to memorize each and every organization. Just pay attention to Invest India, that it is also a partner. IIM Bombay is also a partner. So these are very important organizations that are partnering with the IFSCA for this Sprint 04 Market Tech. Now, the very important point is missed here. What is the focus of this hackathon? What is the central theme? So guys, this hackathon is based on the capital market segment. Okay, so in order to welcome or invite more and more technological innovative solutions in the capital market segment, this hackathon has been organized. Now, as I told you that it has 5 problem areas, which of course you do not need to memorize, just the number would do for your preparation of phase 1. So these are the problem areas. I have mentioned them. If you want to have a look at them, do read it when you will get the PDF. Otherwise, I think you don't need to go into the details of these 5 problem areas. Okay, moving ahead, recently Jomo soup has been added to the UNESCO list of intangible cultural heritage. Which country does this soup belong to? So the very peculiar thing about this soup is that it is known as the freedom soup in the country that we are going to answer here. So which country is it? It's Haiti. Okay, so this soup, it has a very cultural relevance. This is the freedom soup, okay, which is basically a symbol of things long forbidden to slaves under the French domination. So freedom refers to the freedom, of course. So here the people enjoy the soup in order to celebrate their freedom from the French dominance, and they got the independence on this date. Since this UNESCO news is in the UNESCO list is in the news because of Haiti's soup, therefore this date can also be asked from you. If you don't memorize the exact date, year to yaad rakhna bahut zaruri hai, that is 1804. But I would advise that if you can, then do remember the entire date on which Haiti got its independence. Next question is, which of the following category has been added for the first time in the Raksha Mantri Awards for Excellence 2021? So we have implementation of eChhavni project, digital accomplishments, innovation in public services, land and record management, Swachh Chhavni, Swasth Chhavni. So these are the 5 categories. Now, out of these options, option A, that is implementation of the eChhavni project, is the new category that has been added into this awards That is given by the Ministry of Defense. Okay, now these awards were given on a very special day, that is the 96th Raising Day of Directorate General Defense Estates, which is in New Delhi. The categories of the awards are here. Okay, of which implementation of each Harmony project is a new category, and the one category that we did not discuss is this improvement in containment general hospital. So guys, what is this each Harmony project for which a new category has been added into this awards? Each Harmony is the project of the Ministry of Defense wherein all the information of the containment boards across India, 62 containment boards are there. So all the information of the day-to-day activities that are going on, the developmental activities or the basic necessary services that are there, all of these activities are provided on this platform, each Harmony, for the convenience of the residents who are living in the containment board. So that's the whole project. That's the whole portal all about. Okay? Each Harmony, wherein the information of the containment board is provided. Now, I would like to ask a question from you all. My question is the year in which the Each Harmony project was launched by the Ministry of Defense. Now, related to this news only, you also need to know that while announcing the awards, the Raksha Mantri, that is the Defense Minister, has inaugurated the Center of Excellence in the field of survey technology for capacity building. So this Center of Excellence has been set up by the National Institute of Defense Estate Management. And this is the central institute which provides professional training to the officers and employees of the Defense Estates Departments. So no need to memorize this much. You just need to know that this is the institution that has set up this Center of Excellence, which was inaugurated by the Defense Minister. Next, the center will focus on new techniques of survey, that is drone surveying and simultaneous localization and mapping technologies. Again, this is an additional point. Next, which state has launched the Sahai scheme? So here the right answer is Jharkhand. Very easy question, I would say. This is the easiest question of all the questions that I have taken up for today's video. So in this scheme, basically the purpose is to shift the focus of the youth from the Maoist hit activities, from the Maoist activities towards sports, so that they can also become productive citizens. That's the whole scheme that the scheme is all about. Now the full form of Sahai is sports action towards harnessing aspirations of youth. Okay, so this is the full form. Now, there is one central government portal also, which is named as Sahai. That is GEM Sahai. Okay, so this portal and this scheme, both of them are totally different. Now, this portal of government e-marketplace, this portal aims to provide the financial services, financial help to the suppliers or the proprietors who are listed on this GEM portal for providing the goods for which the government departments place orders. So whenever any order comes to these proprietors, if they need any finances, so those for those finances, they can apply through this GEM Sahai portal. This is an entirely different portal and this scheme is entirely different. Since the names are same, therefore there can be a confusion, but now I hope that there would not be any confusion. My question from you is again from the year. In which year was this GEM Sahai portal launched by the government? Also, which ministry is administering this portal? Do mention both of these things in the comment section below. Next question is related to the target, that too, one of the components of renewable energy. So this is again very important. What is the nuclear power capacity target of India by 2031? So here the right answer is 22,480 megawatts. Recently, the Minister of State for this, Department of State and Department of Atomic Energy, that is Jitendra Singh. So he has informed Rajya Sabha that right now we have 6,780 megawatt of installed nuclear power capacity, which we aim to increased to 22,480 megawatts by 2031. So guys, this is the target, and they have specifically mentioned the target for nuclear energy. So you have to memorize this target. This is important for you to know. Now also know that presently the nuclear power, the nuclear generated electricity comprises of 3.1% of the total energy that we have or that we generate. Okay, so 3.1% is the contribution by the nuclear power in the total electricity mix. Next question is, recently Union Minister for Rural Development and Panchayati Raj Shri Giriraj Singh launched MIS portal for ranking of states and UTs in land acquisition projects. What is the total marks in the ranking? So here I just played the trick so that I can acquaint you with the mind of the examiner. It may be possible that the examiner might not go into this much detail, but still you cannot let your guard down. You have to prepare holistically. And these are the minute points from where the examiners deliberately pick up the, make the questions. Because also you need to know that the sources from where the examiner makes the questions are the newspapers and the PIB. So this was in PIB, therefore there are high chances that this can also be asked. I remember that in one of your RBI examination, like in 2019, I guess, or prior to that, there was a question on the total number of projects that have been approved under the National Infrastructure Pipeline. This was a question in your examination. So if this can be asked, then definitely this can become a question. So now let's come back to the answer. 140 is the total number of marks for out of which states will be given the marks. So first of all, let's understand what this portal is. The name of this portal is Vikas Portal. Okay. Now the basic purpose of this portal is to rank the states and UTs on the basis of the progress made in land acquisition. So let me simplify it. There is a portal that has been launched by the central government. The purpose of this portal is to rank the states and union territories. Now, on what basis will the states and UTs be ranked? They will be ranked on the basis of land acquisition for the developmental projects. We all know that if the government needs to establish any developmental project in any of the state or in any of the city, it needs to acquire land for it. And how fastly the state is enabling the center to acquire the land for certain project is the basis of this ranking. Okay, and the data for the ranking will be collected through this Vikas portal. So that's the whole idea of this Vikas portal. I hope that now it is clear. Also remember that the ranking or the land acquisition will be done under this Right to Fair Compensation and Transparency in Land Acquisition, Rehabilitation and Resettlement Act of 2013. The land acquisition that is done under this act will be counted for the ranking. That will be done through this Vikas portal by using the information that the states and union territories will themselves provide to this portal. Okay, so I have told you this point. The portal will provide all the information related to the acquisition of land for developmental projects. Now if the center gets to know that which state is being ranked at the first position, which state is allowing the faster acquisition of land, then it would be easier for the central government to convince the states that are not allowing to do so in order to increase the development of that state also. Now let's understand it with a better example. Suppose if we have Gujarat on the one hand, Gujarat, and on the other hand, we have West Bengal. Okay, we all know what kind of political situation these states are in. So Gujarat is one state that is completely at present led by the BJP government, that is in the center too, and West Bengal is the Mamata Banerjee state. Okay, so we know that due to the political instability, states tend to deviate from the developmental projects. They do not allow the state, or basically they do not cooperate with the center in the land acquisition and other auxiliary services. So if the Gujarat is being ranked at the top position, and similarly other states which are cooperating more with the center in developmental projects, then the center knows that, okay, these are the states that are cooperating with us, but these are the states that are not cooperating with us. Therefore, we need to ensure, we need to increase the cooperation with these states so that the developmental projects, the pace of the developmental projects can be increased and the overall development of our nation can be done. So that's the whole purpose that this portal will serve. It will inform the state, the center, about the progress of the developmental projects of the, for example, hospital, highways, etc. These are the developmental projects. So on the basis of the progress made in these projects, states and UTs will be judged. This has been developed, this portal has been developed by the Department of Land Resources. Now, the minute facts related to the ranking from where question would be framed in your examination. First of all, land which is acquired after 1st January 2014 under the act that we talked about will be counted for ranking. Okay, so this is the date. Each state and union territory will get marks out of total 140 marks. Negative marking will also be done for delaying the implementation of developmental projects. Now guys, this also plays a very important role in terms of FDI that the states seek to attract within their own state. Okay, so if the negative marking is there, if the ranking is too low, no foreign investor would be willing to invest in that state. States and union territories will share data on the portal. Portal will itself create the ranking based on the data, so there would not be any involvement of the Department of Land Resources or any central ministry. So it is entirely transparent and automotive, on the auto mode. Okay, so the portal itself is creating the ranking. There is no involvement of the center. Top three states and top three districts will be awarded. So guys, here the video ends. I know that you are waiting for the GK factory section, but today for a change I thought not to bring the GK factory section, because I have been doing that, and if I continue to do that, there would be no surprise for you. But that does not mean that I have stopped the GK factory section. No guys, not at all. GK factory is continued and it will continue. Okay, so milte hain kal acche new facts ke saath, and tomorrow there will be a GK factory section also. Okay, thank you so much guys, and if you like the content, then do like this video, subscribe to our channel and hit the bell notification.